learn about the new chapter called Motions of the Earth. All the objects in the space, they move, right? What are such objects? Stars, planets, and other heavenly objects like meteoroids, comets, satellites, etc. Same way, the Earth's planet also is moving. So Earth moves in two directions. Let's see what are those directions. The two directions in which Earth moves are known as rotation and revolution. So Earth rotates on its own axis. That means it rotates around itself. And also, while rotating around itself, it revolves around the sun. So rotation of the Earth. Rotation of the Earth means Earth spins or rotates itself from west to east direction. So this spin of the Earth on its own axis from west to east is known as rotation. And what is the time period taken to complete one rotation? It is 24 hours. So Earth takes 24 hours to complete one rotation. Now what is the speed of the rotation? It is 1671 kilometers per hour speed. So in this image, students, you are able to see the rotation of the Earth, that is rotating around its own axis. So this is the direction of the Earth spin, and the middle one is equator. Upper part is known as the north pole and the lower part is known as the south pole. And sun is falling from this direction. So Earth is rotating around its own axis. Now let's study about the effects of Earth's rotation. This rotation of the Earth only results in changing of the time from day to night. And this rotation is only responsible for bulging of the Earth near the equator and flattening of the Earth at the poles. So Earth is spherical in shape, right? It is bulged in the middle, that is towards the equator. And ocean current and deflection of the winds is also caused by rotation of the Earth. And the rise and fall of the oceans is due to the gravity of the moon and the sun, and also the rotation of the Earth and movement of the sun, stars, celestial bodies, and all these bodies from the east to west is also because of the rotation of the Earth. So in this image, you students, you see the formation of day and night because of the rotation of the Earth. This is the day part on one half of the Earth, and this is the night part. And then this is the rotation of the Earth. It is during the night time, and this is during the day time. This is during the daytime. Next, students, let's learn about day and night. So day and night are caused because of rotation of the Earth. So when Earth rotates from west to east, the sun rises in the east, that is the daytime. So Earth rotates from the west to east and the sun rises in the east. Children, all of us know that Earth is spherical in shape, right? So because it is spherical in shape, only one side of the Earth can face the sun, as shown in this image. See, one part of the Earth can face the sunlight. So that part of the Earth will have the daytime at that point. That part of the Earth which faces the sun experiences the daytime. And that part of the Earth which is turned away from the sun experiences the night time. Okay? So that is the reason people living in India will have day and people living in America will have night. That is why, because of Earth's rotation. It is a line that separates the lighted half from the darker half. So one half of the Earth will have daytime, one half of the Earth will have night time, right? So the line which separates this light and the darker part of the Earth is known as circle of illumination. So this is the straight line which is known as the circle of illumination. So in a given 24 hours time, Earth experiences many stages, such as dawn, sunrise, early morning, then midday, afternoon, then evening sunset we have around 5 or 6 p.m. and then we have dusk at the night time, and then again after the night dawn starts. So what is dawn? Dawn is that time of the day before sunrise, and dusk is the time of the day after sunset. So sun rises in the east, sun sets in the west, right? Dawn is the time of the day before sunrise, and dusk is the time of the day after sunset in the west. And this image, you can see the circle of illumination. This is the middle line. One part of the Earth is facing the sun, having the daytime, and the other darker side is having the night time. Let's talk about the revolution of the Earth. What is the definition of revolution? Revolution is nothing but the movement of the Earth around the sun. Earth, while rotating around its own axis, also it revolves around the sun. So that movement of Earth around the sun is known as the revolution. So it takes either 365 days or 1 year to complete one revolution around the sun. So the path in which Earth revolves around the sun is known as orbit.
So the direction in which Earth revolves around the Sun is known as the orbit, and the Earth's orbit is always elliptical in shape, that is oval or egg-shaped. So during the early January, the distance between the Earth and the Sun is minimum almost 147 million kilometers. This is the perihelion period. So in the early January, the distance between the Earth and the Sun is 147 million kilometers, and this period is called as perihelion, and maximum it will go up to 152 million kilometers in the July. So in the January it is called perihelion. In July it is known as aphelion, because the kilometers is almost 152 kilometers. So this period in which the plane in which the Earth goes around the Sun is called ecliptic. You need to know the difference between orbit and ecliptic. So in this image, students, you see the revolution of the Earth. The Earth is revolving around the Sun like an orbit, taking an oval-shaped path, right? So now let's learn about the effects of Earth revolution. So the revolution of the Earth, along with the tilt in the Earth's axis, so Earth's axis is like verifying length of the day and night. Seasonal changes. See, if there was Earth's axis was straight and not tilted, then what happens? You know, there will be no seasonals at all. Whole year we will be having the same type of season. So the Earth's axis, because it is tilted, have different. We experience different seasons, and every point on the Earth would receive the same amount of light each day. We will always have same amount of light every day of the year. The way of day and night. See, how is the varying length of the day and night? Say half of the year, so January, northern hemisphere faces the Sun, and for the next 6 months, that is June to December, southern hemisphere faces. That is why length and day length keep changing. So that part of the hemisphere which faces the Sun gets daytime of the day, that is it receives the sunlight, and that part of the Sun which is away from the hemisphere do not get sun for long time, right? So hemisphere which is facing the Sun gets longer days and shorter nights. Hemisphere which is not facing the Sun, it will get longer nights and shorter days. And at the point of equator, the day and nights are always equal, okay? So the Earth's axis always tilted, right? It is inclined at an angle of 23.5 degrees to perpendicular plane. When this tilting axis is combined with the revolution of the Earth, so this tilt axis combined with the revolution of the Earth, we get the seasonal changes. So the northern hemisphere in the early parts of January, it is inclined towards the Sun, and the southern hemisphere is turned away from the Sun between 21 March to 23 September. Because northern pole is inclined towards the Sun, the northern hemisphere has both longer days and shorter nights, and this part of the Earth gets heated more, and always it is summer here. Southern hemisphere is definitely away from the Sun, right? And it gets only few slanting rays of the Sun, not too bright rays. Here in the southern hemisphere, the nights are longer and the days are shorter, so the climate is always better here. So on 21st June, sun rays fall on the Tropic of Cancer, and this is known as the longest day of the year, so known as the summer solstice. So 21 of June every year is known as the longest day of the year, because sun rays fall directly on the Tropic of Cancer, and this is known as summer solstice. So on the Tropic of Capricorn, 22nd December every year, the sun rays fall vertically, and then this is known as the shortest day of the year. And this shortest day of the year, which occurs in the northern hemisphere, it is known as the winter solstice. In this image, you see the changing seasons. September 22 to 23, perihelion, January 3, March you have equinox, and then June you have solstice between June 21 to 22, and then there is aphelion on July 4. So that is how revolution of the Earth around the Sun changes the seasons. Next, let's study about equinox. So the period between 21st of March and 23 of September every year, on the 2 days, sun rays fall directly on the equator, and those days are known as the equinox. So during this time, in the North Pole and the South Pole are neither inclined towards the Sun or nor they are away from it. These 2 days, maximum number of heat and light is received at the equator, and during this period, both the hemispheres receive equal amount of sun rays. That is the reason the length of the day and night is equal all over the world. and March 21 every year is known as the vernal or the spring equinox, and September 23 is known as the autumn equinox. Next, let's learn about the four seasons. Different position of the earth during revolution around the sun is responsible for different seasons on the earth. So what are the four seasons on the earth? In the northern hemisphere, there is always spring begins in March, and in June comes summer, and in September comes autumn, and in December comes winter. So this is how three seasons occur: spring, summer, autumn and winter. And in the southern hemisphere, what happens? Here autumn begins in March. It is different from that of the northern hemisphere. And then winter occurs in June, spring occurs in September and summer occurs in December. So northern and southern hemispheres have different seasons at different months of the year. So in this image, we can see the different seasons changing due to the Earth's revolution. Equinox we are able to see, it's December solstice we are able to see, June solstice we are able to see. So all this because of different revolution around the sun. Next, let's learn about the leap year. So the Earth, to complete one revolution around the sun, the Earth requires 365 days plus 1/4 day. One revolution around the sun, Earth takes 365 days plus 6 hours, and this 6 hours will be added once in 4 years. So that one day extra is present once in every 4 years. So that every 4th year has 366 days, and it is known as leap year. Some children even have their birthday on 29th February, right? Which comes only once in 4 years.